Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Abdul Ghafur. I am a med student from UIN Syarif Hidayatullah, Jakarta. I am going to express my opinion about the importance of determining the quadratism with spherical trigonometry method. Islam is a religion in which all its followers are required to carry out the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that have been revealed to his messengers and stay away from his prohibition. One of the commands is to pray towards the city of Mecca, precisely at the Kaaba, which is also known as the Qibla direction. But how do we know the direction of the Kaaba accurately if we live in country far from the Kaaba? Many different methods have been widely applied, from looking at the cardinal direction and a position of the star, even using mathematical calculation. Among the assistant mathematical calculation methods, one of them is the spherical trigonometry method. This method utilizes a triangle on a sphere connected by three points as a reference in the calculation. In determining the calibration, the three points are in the form of geographical location, including the location of the Kaaba, the North Pole, and the city where the Qibla direction will be found. Thus, I think it is important for us to determine the Qibla direction accurately using the spherical trigonometry method. But, firstly, why do we need to know the Qibla direction accurately? This is because facing the Qibla direction is a condition for the validity of Muslim prayers. As the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Quran Surah Al-Baqarah verse 150, from wherever you come out, then turn your face towards the Grand Mosque, and wherever you are, then turn your face towards it. And in addition, accurate Qibla direction also important for Muslims as a reference in carrying out sunnah. According to Imam Bukhari, in his hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam faced the Qibla during Ihram in Hajj and after throwing the Jumratul Wusta, and forbade facing or backing from the Qibla direction when relieving oneself. Furthermore, according to the rules of manners, the Qibla direction is also the direction of the animal's face when it is slaughtered, and the direction of the corpse face when it is buried. Therefore, we must know more about the Qibla direction in our area to get a more perfect reward. Secondly, we need to determine the Qibla direction accurately with the spherical trigonometry method because this method is part of Allied science, which is very important to obtain a more accurate Qibla direction, as stated by the fatwa of the Indonesian Ulama Council MUI No. 5 of 2010, which states that the Qibla of Indonesian Muslim is facing northwest with varying position according to the location of its region, which means we can consider the input of the Falak Science practitioners on the accuracy of the measurement aspect according to the location of its region. The fatwa was delivered as an explanation of the previous MUI fatwa, which said that the Qibla of Indonesian Muslim is facing west, which is according to the practitioners of Falak Science. This previous fatwa is less precise because Indonesia is not really east of Kaaba. Thirdly, using the spherical trigonometry method will also provide a correct result because it uses calculation that consider the actual shape of the earth and uses a framework from the geodetic theory that can provide the closest direction calculation following the assumption of the actual shape of the earth. Spherical trigonometry also considers the density of the earth and the distance between the observer's location and the Kaaba, so that it can provide more accurate results than the usual trigonometric method. Based on research conducted by Miswanto in his journal, Telaah Ketepatan dan Keakuratan dalam Penentuan Arah Kiblat, it was concluded that the theory of spherical trigonometry is more precise and accurate than the Napier analogy formula in determining the qiblat direction. Therefore, the spherical trigonometry method is also more often used than another method in determining the qiblat direction in masjid. Thus, based on the fact, it has been shown the spherical trigonometry method can determine the qiblat direction accurately. So you should do mathematical calculation using this method to find out whether the qiblat in your area is accurate or not. Do not just follow the qiblat direction that already exists in your area. This is so that we can all get a more perfect possibility following the laws in the Quran and Hadith. With correct qiblat direction, not only will you get the wisdom, but it will also benefit the people around you and become a good deed in the sight of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. For this reason, it is important for Muslims to get a correct qiblat direction. So we should use the spherical trigonometry method to get a correct qiblat direction. So that's my recommendation about the importance of determining qiblat direction with spherical trigonometry method. Thank you for watching. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.